Hey everyone, my name is Xavier, and in this video, we will continue working on our little JavaScript blockchain implementation. In the last two videos, we created our blockchain and we secured it with the proof of work algorithm. In this video, I'm going to expand it a little bit and make it a simple cryptocurrency. To do that, we're going to do two things. Number one, we're going to make it so that a block can contain multiple transactions. And number two, we're going to add rewards for miners. Now, why would we want to do that? Well, when you start a cryptocurrency, you need to have virtual money or coins. And if you don't introduce them somewhere in the system, no one can get any coins. Mining rewards steadily introduce new coins into the system. So let's get going. Here I've opened up the source code of the last two videos in Visual Studio Code, and I'm going to start by removing all of our test code near the bottom. We're going to refactor a bunch of this stuff, so this won't work anyway. I'm just going to keep the SavG coin instance. Next, I'm going to modify the block class a bit so that it supports multiple transactions. So instead of receiving a data field, I'm going to say that it receives transactions. That makes a little bit more sense. And we're going to say this.transactions equals transactions. I'm also going to remove the index argument right here because I've added that in the first video, but it's actually not useful in a blockchain. The order of blocks is determined by their position in the array and not by the index that we can pass here. So when I remove index from the constructor of block here, I also have to remove it from our genesis block down here. All right, so this transaction argument will get an array of transactions. So let's define what a transaction looks like by creating a new class for a transaction. And I'm going to say that a transaction receives a from address, a to address, and an amount. This is pretty straightforward. A transaction always comes from someone, it goes to someone, and it carries a certain amount of coins. And then we're just going to assign each of these. So from address equals from address, this dot to address equals to address, this dot amount equals amount. With that out of the way, we can start working on our main blockchain class. There are a few things that we have to do here. We have to add a mining reward, we need a place to store pending transactions, and we need a new method to mine a new block for the pending transactions. Now you might ask yourself, what is this pending transaction stuff and why do I need it? Well, it's because we only create blocks on a specific interval. In Bitcoin's case, the proof of work algorithm makes sure that there is only one block created every 10 minutes. All the transactions that are made in between blocks are temporarily stored in this pending transactions array so that they can be included in the next block. So let's start with simple things first. I'm going to add a new property to our blockchain class for our pending transactions. So I'm going to call it this.pendingTransactions equals an empty array. And then I'm also going to define a property that will control how much coins the miners get as reward. So I'm going to say this.miningReward equals, let's say, 100 coins if you successfully mine a new block. I'm also going to reduce the difficulty a bit so that it's just faster to test, and then we can increase it again when we're done with our changes. Now that we have these changes, we're going to work on our new mining method. So this was our old mining method, the add block method, and I'm going to replace that by mine pending transactions. Now, mine pending transactions, this will receive an address. It will receive a mining reward address. So when a miner calls this method, it will pass along its wallet address and say, hey, if I successfully mine this block, then send the reward to this address. Now, inside this method, we will start by creating a new block. So I would say let block equals a new block. That requires a timestamp, so I'm going to say date.now, and then it requires some transactions, so we're going to pass along this.pendingTransactions. We're going to give it all of our pending transactions that are currently stored in our blockchain. Now, in real-world cryptocurrencies like, again, for instance, Bitcoin, adding all the pending transactions to a block isn't possible because there are way too many pending transactions and because the block size cannot increase 1 megabyte. So instead, miners get to choose which transactions they include and which they don't. But we're not going to worry about this in our simple example, but just be aware that in reality, miners have to pick the transactions that they want to include. So after creating the block, let's mine it. We're gonna say block.mineblock, and we're gonna mine it with the difficulty that is currently set within our blockchain. Right now it's 2. And if that's done, we're gonna log something to the console. We're gonna say block successfully mined. And then we're going to add it to our chain. So we're gonna say this.chain.push our block. And the last two things that we have to do is reset the pending transactions array and create a new transaction to give the miner his reward. Now we can do this all in one go. We can just say that this.pendingTransactions equals an empty array that will reset the pending transactions, but we can also just define an array with just one new element. So we can say new transaction. The from address, we're gonna say null, because there isn't really a from address in a mining reward. It just comes out of this system. It's the algorithm that gives it to you. We're gonna send it to the mining reward address. And how much coins are we going to send? This.miningRewards. Now in the previous video, some people pointed out that they can change this code right here and give themselves more coins. And that's true, you really could do that. However, cryptocurrencies are powered by a peer-to-peer network, and other nodes in the network won't accept your attempts of fooling them, and instead they will just ignore you. So that's something that I wanted to address from the previous videos. Now to continue, I'm also going to create a simple method called createTransaction, and this will receive a transaction, and all this will do is add this to the pending transactions array. So we're going to push it onto that array. All right, now the final thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a method that checks the balance of an address. Many people think that if you send some bitcoins around, they actually move away from your wallet's balance to someone else's balance. But in reality, you don't really have a balance. The transaction is just stored on the blockchain, and if you ask for your balance, you have to go through all the transactions that involve your address and calculate it that way. So let's create a method for this. I'm going to call this get balance of address, and it will of course receive an address that we have to check its balance. We're going to say that the balance starts at 0, and then we're going to loop over all the blocks in our blockchain. So we're going to say for constant block of this.chain, and because our blocks now contain multiple transactions, we're going to say loop over each transaction of the transactions inside this block. And then we have to write a bit of logic. If you are the from address, that means that you've transferred money away from your wallet to someone else. So we have to reduce your balance. And if you are the to address, then you were the receiver of a transaction and we have to increase your balance. So we're going to say if transaction from address equals the address that was given here and its address, then we're going to reduce your balance with the amount of the transaction. And if the to address equals the address that you gave us, then we're going to increase your balance with the amount of the transaction. And when we're done looping over all the blocks and all the transactions, we're just going to return the balance that you have. All right, so now it's finally time to test our code. I'm gonna scroll down, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create some transactions. I'm gonna say sagicoin.createTransaction, and we're gonna make a new transaction object here, new transaction. This has a from address. I'm just gonna give it random strings here, address 1 to address 2, and it will send address 2, let's say 100 coins. And then we're going to repeat that, and then we're going to say that address 2, for instance, gives address 1 50 coins back, something like that. Now in reality, address 1 and address 2 would be the public key of someone's wallet. After we've created these new transactions, they will be pending. They will be in the pending transactions array. So we have to start the miner to actually create a block for them and store them on our blockchain. So I'm going to say console.log, new line, starting the miner, And then I'm going to say savgcoin.minePendingTransactions. And this method expects a mining reward address. In other words, it wants to know where it should send the mining reward to. So I'm just going to create another fake address. I'm going to say Xavier's address. And after that is done, we're going to check my balance. So we're going to say console log balance of Xavier is. And then we're going to say savgcoin.getBalance of address, Xavier's address. All right, so let's save the file and let's open the terminal and run it to see if it actually works. So I'm going to say node source main.js. And yeah, kind of works, starting the miner, mine the block, but then it says my balance is still zero. Well, actually that's correct, because in our mining method, if you remember, after a block has been mined, we create a new transaction to give you your mining reward, but that one is added to the pending transactions array. So the mining reward will only be sent when the next block is mined. So let's mine another one then. We say console.log. I'm gonna put that, just copy it and put it there. So starting the miner again, and then we're gonna check my balance again, right there, save it, run it again, and sure enough, the second time it increased our balance to 100. But in mining our second block, I also get a new reward, which is again in the pending transaction state and will again be included in the next block that is mined. So that concludes this video. We've transformed our blockchain into a very simple cryptocurrency where a block can contain multiple transactions and where miners get 100 coins in mining rewards. Now, I want to point out that this is a simplified version of a cryptocurrency and it's for education purposes. Don't try to make your own cryptocurrency with this. So that's it for now. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure that you hit the subscribe button and also like this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.